Once the companion of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Hanzala radiallahu an, Abu Bakr radiallahu an, passed by him, and he asked him, "How are you, ya Hanzala?" And Hanzala radiallahu an, he said, "Nafaqa Hanzala," that Hanzala has become a munafiq. Basically, I have become a munafiq. So Abu Bakr radiallahu an was surprised, and he asked him, "What are you saying? Why are you saying this? What happened?" And then Hanzala radiallahu an, he said, "When I am with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and he is speaking about Jannah and he is speaking about Jahannam, he's speaking about the hereafter, it is as if I am seeing it with my own eyes. I feel that it is at a level, my iman is at a level that I am seeing what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is describing with my own eyes, like I can see Jannah and I can see Jahannam, the way that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam describes it. So when I'm in his presence, this is how I feel. But then after I leave, then I go back to my wife, I go back to my children, go back to my business, and a lot of that feeling is gone. I'm not at the same level as I am when I am in the presence of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam." So Hanzala, he felt that this is a form of nifaq, that he feels something with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but then when he is with his family, that feeling is not so strong in him anymore. So he explained this to Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. And then Abu Bakr said, "You know, I actually feel the same way. The same thing happens with me. When I'm with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and he's explaining these things, I feel as if I can see it. But then when I'm dealing with my family and dealing with my daily life, then a lot of that feeling, it's not the same." So they both were afraid. So they decided to go to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and tell him about this worry that they had. So they went to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, both of them, Hanzala and Abu Bakr radiallahu anhuma. And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked Hanzala regarding his situation, and he said the same thing. He said, "Nafaqa Hanzala," I have become a munafiq. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked him, "What are you saying? Why are you saying this?" And he explained the same thing that he explained to Abu Bakr, that when I'm with you, I feel that I can see what you are describing. You talk about Jannah, it's like I can see it with my eyes. You talk about Jahannam, it's like I can see it with my eyes. That presence of heart is very strong. But then when I go to my family, I go to my wife, I go to my children, I go to my business, a lot of that feeling, it's not there anymore, as strong as it was when I'm with you. So then the Prophet ﷺ explained to Hanzala that this is not nifaq, this is not hypocrisy, this is normal. And the Prophet ﷺ said, "وَالَّذِي نَفْسِي بِيَدِهِ لَوْ تَدُومُونَ عَلَى مَا تَكُونُونَ عِنْدِي وَفِي الذِّكْرِ لَصَافَحَتْكُمُ الْمَلَائِكَةَ عَلَى فُرُشِكُمْ وَفِي طُرُقِكُمْ." That if you were to stay in the same state as you are in when you are in my presence, if you keep that feeling with you all the time, then the angels would come and they would shake your hands in your beds and on the streets. وَلَكِنْ سَاعَةً وَسَاعَةً Sa'a wa sa'a, sa'a wa sa'a. The Prophet ﷺ said, "There's a time for this and there's a time for that. There's a time for this, there's a time for that. There's a time for your worship and there's a time for your complete presence of heart in thinking about Jannah and Jahannam. There's a time for that, absolutely. But then there's also a time for you to take care of your family, for you to enjoy your time with your children, for you to be with your friends, of course, all in a halal way. There's a time for that as well. And there is no concept of being a monk in Islam. Like in Christianity, they have these monks who like completely leave off the dunya and they isolate themselves inside the monastery and they spend all of their time in worship. Either they're praying or they're sleeping or eating, and that's it. That's their whole life. They don't get married. They don't have families. They have no connection to the world at all. These monks in Christianity, but Islam has no concept of that. That's not how we are supposed to be in Islam. And the Prophet ﷺ was the best example, that he would spend time in worship, but then he would also spend time with his family, he would spend time with his children, with his grandchildren, with his companions, right? So this is a very important hadith that shows us how to have a balance in our lives. Sa'atan wa sa'a. And he repeated it three times. Sa'atan wa sa'a, sa'atan wa sa'a, sa'atan wa sa'a. Time for this, a time for that. A time for this, a time for that. A time for this and a time for that. And it teaches us that The reality is, if somebody goes to extremes in their worship, then they will eventually burn out. They will burn out. And there are many cases of people who have just overexerted themselves in a way that they're not prescribed to do, and they found it too difficult, and then they rebounded completely. They left everything altogether. They said, this is too hard, forget it, I don't want to deal with this anymore. And sadly, this is even the way that some teachers teach children in some countries, when they teach Quran, for example. There are some teachers who will not give their students any rest. You have to memorize the Quran, you have to spend all day doing it, no time to rest, no time to play, you know, from morning to evening, just sit with the Quran and just read all day. And they do this for months and maybe years on end. What happens to these children in the end? In the end, yeah, maybe they memorize the Quran, but they're so burned out by that experience that when they're free, when they finish the Quran, then sometimes they completely abandon it. They say, okay, that was such a difficult chapter in my life. Now, they don't want to have any memories of that anymore. And they leave the Quran. And I know people who have memorized the Quran in this way, under such a strenuous and hard schedule with no time for rest or relaxation, under very strict rules by their teachers. And then once they finish, that's it. They don't revise it, they don't care to keep their relationship with the Quran, and they forget it. This is common. This is common because they don't follow the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, sa'atan wa sa'a. A time for this, a time for that. You teach your kids Quran, yes, but you don't burn them out by making them spend all of their time only doing that, with no time to rest, no time to play. No, this is not right. Rather, we have to have a balance in our lives, and if you have a balance in your life, then you will be successful in both scales of the balance. You will be successful in your religious obligations, you will be able to worship in a good way with proper focus and khushu', and the time that you spend with your family and your friends, and the time you spend relaxing and resting, that will also be something that you enjoy as well. And it will rejuvenate you, it will refresh you, so that you can do your ibadah. When the time comes for your ibadah, you'll be able to do it with full focus. So this is a very important concept that we need to understand, and we need to teach our children the religion in this way. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow us to have these balances, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow us to instill these balances in our children as well. It's very important for a proper religious upbringing. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us fulfill this responsibility. Ameen. والله أعلم صلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين.